Hello, beautiful people. Honest Am here, the creator and writer of the Honestly Sis newsletter, a bi-weekly newsletter geared towards millennials who are truly trying to get their shit together. And I am here for another daily motivational video where I use the tarot to become the alchemist of our lives. A little bit about me. I do not just use the tarot. I use God and cusses in the same sentence, and I may mispronounce some things. But if it does not stop Charlemagne the God, it will not stop me. All right, angel number 23. Let's go ahead and get right on into it. God, what messages do you have for us to become the alchemists of our lives, to help bring heaven on earth, or just to do magic in public? God, what messages do you deem worthy for us to hear at this time? Please deliver these messages to me and through me as clear as possible. In God's name I pray. Ashe. All right, y'all. So this is going to be a little bit different. As you see, angel number 53, I have grabbed my I Am affirmation cards. And this is actually a channeling that just came to me. So I told you guys I'm trying to learn how to trust my ebb and flows, and the cards was calling to me again. So here I am. I honestly wanted to take my hair down and do a whole bunch of other stuff, but this is where we are. So the messages that came out, is angel number 30 and angel number 16 is, I am perceptive. My intuition is powerful. When I am unsure, my intuition is sure. I strengthen my intuition. Oh, excuse me. We started over. Angel number 130. My intuition is powerful. When I am unsure, my intuition is sure. I strengthen my intuition by trusting it and responding to its impulses. I am perceptive. And so this message is going to be about, how do you feel about your intuition? Are you using your intuition? Do you feel like you are perceptive? And I feel like God is going to give you some tools that you may need to strengthen your intuition. The card that also came out is, I am worthy. I am enough, and I am worthy of receiving everything I desire. I do not need to prove myself to those who seek to diminish me. I am worthy. And so I really feel like this message is going to be all about you learning how to strengthen your intuition, you knowing that the desires, those visions, those dreams that you have on your heart, you are worthy of creating them, and God put them on your heart for a reason. And now he's going to give you the tools and the steps you need to feel more confident and more worthy about yourself. Underneath this is, I am happy. And it says, I take control of my happiness. When my happiness depends on others' actions, I am at the mercy of things I cannot control. Instead, I choose to cultivate consistent happiness by focusing on the things I love about myself. I am happy. And so I feel like this message is all about you learning how to block out the external world, block out the need for external validation, and to really learn to trust yourself and your intuition. So, God, look at this, beautiful. And God is saying, you have the power within you. That's why he's saying, be perceptive, plant those seeds so that you can get the ultimate blessing that you want. And you are the magician. You're worthy enough to be the magician and to bring those inspirations to life. So that was like a right off the top, like a confirmation. But I want to know, God, what is our energy towards our intuition? Do we feel confident in our intuition? Do we use our intuition? Have we been trusting our intuition? Do we feel worthy of, creating our... Do we feel worthy of bringing our dreams to life, of having the things that we desire? Are we taking control of our happiness, or are we at the whim of the world? God, please give us the messages and the cards that we need to clarify this message of, I am perceptive, I am perceptive, I am worthy, and I am happy. Make it as plain as possible. In God's name I pray. Ashe. Wow. So with I am perceptive, this is, everything is fine. So right now you may be feeling as though you are just having a lot of things that are closing, a lot of chapters that are closing in your life. You've probably really have done the work to kind of understand yourself and understand how you communicate with others. And I feel like you're at the end of this cycle. And honestly, I don't even know if this card is technically supposed to be in here, but we know that this is the Ten of Swords, and this Ten of Swords represents completion of a cycle of struggle. And so that's why God is trying to get you to understand that there's no need to doubt yourself anymore. And maybe in the past you have been betrayed. Maybe in the past you didn't, you put yourself in situations to where you betrayed yourself and you couldn't trust yourself, angel number 501. And that has made you unsure of, you know, trusting your intuition, trusting that you have the abilities to bring your dreams to life. But God is saying all of that is behind you now. Now it's time to really focus on the things that you are trying to create, the things that you are trying to birth into the world, and to really learn to trust your intuition and to just take those steps. And the only way that you can strengthen your intuition is by continuing to trust it, is to just follow those steps. It's like a trial and error. It's just like cooking. Like, the only way you gonna know if you know how to do the dish is if you do it a couple times. So that's really a clear message that God wants to give to you today. Underneath this is, oh, not even underneath this, but the other card that came out is this I am worthy with the Ten of Pentacles. And as we can see right here, the Ten of Pentacles is ultimate happiness, ultimate abundance. Let's not even say happiness, ultimate abundance. And I've really been, the other reason why I wanted to come on here is because I just feel like I've been learning so much within these last two weeks. I don't even think it's been 2 weeks since I recorded, but just really been in this angel number 611, in this like student stage, like just really learning things. Anyways, so I was speaking about, I was watching a video from Sloan Bella, and she was talking about, she's actually a medium and she does a lot of those like celebrity psychic videos and stuff. But this particular video was about manifestation. And she was explaining it about how, you know, sometimes we can get ourselves in trouble with manifestation because we are limiting ourselves. We don't even know the abundance that God has for us because we are saying that we want this one thing. And so, to not confuse you, to give you an example that, you know, you want to say you want this house, say you live in a little small town. Say, matter of fact, just say you live in Detroit and you ain't never been nowhere else. And to you, your ultimate version of happiness or abundance, wealth, is having a house in Indian Village, right? But if you have never been to Beverly Hills or anywhere else, or, you know, if you've never even been down Jefferson where there's houses 10 times bigger, then how do you even know that that's really where God wants you to go? The message that Sloan was trying to give out, and why I really am going to start stepping away from talking about manifestation and really start speaking about alignment. And that's what God wants us to understand, that stop trying to feel like we are smarter than him and trying to, angel number 750, trying to come up with the right words and the right job description, or we have to figure out like what location. You don't have to figure out that part. You could just say, God, I want abundance in my life. And abundance can mean abundance of love. Abundance is abundance. You have abundance of love. You have abundance of money, abundance of food, abundance of relationships. Like, abundance can encompass a lot of different things. And so I feel like what God is saying is, don't waste your time and don't waste your energy of focusing on like just smaller things, these little things. Focus on a big picture. Focus on, you know, like, instead of worrying about, oh God, what job do I need to get, or how can I get a new job? Ask yourself, how can I get into alignment with abundance and with the life that is meant for me? How can I move into alignment with the abundance that is my birthright? That's the prayer that we should be asking for, because if you're praying for a certain job, you could be praying to put yourself back into another form of slavery. I literally just wrote an article about this on Honestly Sis called The Pivot. And it says, thank God for Kofi Syrup in The Pivot. And it's just explaining that we don't know the path that God has for us. And if we just get so gung-ho on, not even getting gung-ho, if we just feel like we know so strongly where we're supposed to be, we could really limit ourselves and really pray for ourselves to be in another form of enslavement or another form of betrayal. So I feel like what God is saying is, instead of trying to figure out that certain job that you need to have, or what type of the amount of money you need to have in your bank account, or the vacation that you need to go on, really think about like, what is abundance mean to you? What will abundance feel like? How can you open up yourself and open up your heart to invite abundance into your life, because that is what you are worthy of. And I feel like for some reason, I feel like this is someone where God has been putting some really, really big dreams on your heart, like some, you know, $1 billion dreams on your heart, some, you know, Jay-Z level, Drake level, Beyonce level dreams on your life. And I feel like you are so nervous about it. You're so scared of even going down the path of even trying to bring this to life. But I say to you, and what I've been realizing is that the answer to your prayers is the idea that you have, that nudge to your intuition, that's the answer to your prayer. And so in order for you to get that physical manifestation of that answer to your prayer, it's going to take for you to take those steps and to walk by faith and not by sight. Angel number 1053, the last message that came out is, I am happy in the King of Swords. And so this card and these two cards together, this tarot card and this affirmation card, is talking all about learning how to take control of your life. If you are constantly going to be at the mercy of everyone else, if you're only going to feel better when you have this man come back into your life, if you're only going to feel better when you have this certain type of job in your life, if you're only going to feel better if you lose 10 pounds, then you are constantly at the mercy of all. Well, maybe the 10 pound part ain't got to do with it. But if you only go be happy when you have this job, or you go on this vacation, or you have this certain dollar amount in your bank account, then you are going to always be at the mercy of things that are outside of your control. And so what God is saying, it's time for you to really think about what makes you happy. How can you start being, one with yourself? Recently, I've been going through like just a lot of like endings, a lot of closures. I've actually kind of been in this place of, I guess, my hermit mode, or this place of isolation. And at first I was just so angry, and I was just so like mad, like, well, God, why would you, how could you take that from me? How could this be my life? And what I realized was that as these things and as these physical people, angel number 1212, was moving out of my life, what happens was the spiritual side came closer. I began to trust my intuition more. I began to be able to communicate with the spiritual side more. I was able to see the intuition and pick up on those subtle glances and those subtle directions. I was able to trust myself more. And also what happened was, when I stepped away from my comfort zone and those people that I wanted to please so much, and those people that I just really wanted to be in my life and God was pushing them out, what I realized was I no longer had to please them. I no longer had to rule my life by anybody control. I realized that I only have to please me at the end of the day. I only am responsible for me and my happiness. And realizing that freed me up and made me just, it really just gave me a sense of freedom. It made me realize that it was my life and it was on me, and I was able to take control. Like, I don't have to play by anybody's rules. I don't have to make anybody happy because ain't nobody around to make happy. So I just say this to say that instead of looking at life as it constantly, something's happening to you, look at it as though it's happening for you. Angel number 1322. So I'm going to ask God, what is a tool that we can use to kind of leave behind these betrayals of our past? How can we leave the baggage of our past behind? Look at that. God is so funny. Okay. My what is need not influence my what is becoming. What is has no bearing on what is coming unless you are continually reiterating the story of what is. By thinking and speaking of how you really want your life to be, you allow what you are currently living to be the jumping off place for so much more. But if you speak predominantly of what is, then you will jump off what you would jump off into more of the same. And so you see this card, you see, though she has literally knives in her body sinking in there, the card says everything is fine. Her attention is not on the pain of this betrayal. Her attention is on shit, I don't know, her timeline, watching the movie. Her attention is on her future and where she's focused and where she's going, angel number 1433. And so that's what God is trying to get you to understand. You're so worried about your past. Nobody's judging you for your past. God's not judging you for your past. The only reason why your past is relevant is because you keep bringing it up. And so what God is trying to say is drop the baggage. Let it go. Learn to trust yourself. Learn to trust other people so that you can get that love and that abundance that you ultimately want and deserve. Your what is need not to influence your what is becoming. Underneath this, God is saying the law of attraction adds to both my problems and my solution. The realization that something is not as you want it to be is an important first step. So again, God is trying to get you to understand the power of your attention and intentions. Come on now. Attention, intentions. I don't know. See, I can't get like Oprah. Angel number 1527. Damn, I want to be like Oprah. Okay. The realization that something is not as you want it to be is an important first step. But once you have identified that, the faster you can turn your attention in the direction of a solution, the better, because a continual exploration of the problem will prevent you from finding the solution. The problem is a different vibrational frequency from the solution, and all thoughts or vibrations are affected and managed by the law of attraction. So again, what God is saying is, I don't care what's going on in your life. I don't care what's blowing up. Be the King of Swords in your life. Learn how to focus your attention. Focus your attention, gain control of your mind as well. A thing that will really help you with this is learning how to get, for one, understand that your solution and the problem is on two different frequencies. So as soon as you realize this is fucked up, I don't like this, I don't want it to be that way, that's the sooner that you can realize, well, hey, I would love for it to be something different, or everything is okay, God got my back. Like, this is when you really need to learn how to implement mantras. And what that has really been helping me a lot. Whenever my mind starts going into that, you know how your mind can just be like, damn, this happened and then that happened, and I can't believe this happened and I wish this didn't happen. What really helps me, instead of doing these shoulda, coulda, wouldas and going down the trail of my past, I say, everything is as it should be. And I got that from, thank you, from Yoga with Adrian. It ain't mine. I say, everything is as it should be. Or if I find myself like thinking about my past or thinking about somebody in my past, or I'm nervous or something happened in my life that I'm like, it's an inconvenience to me. And instead of just going down and being like, oh, this is, you know, this is so fucked up, blah, 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 this is going, instead of like making the problem bigger than what it is, I just say, God in the universe is for me. It has my back. It wants the best for me. It's going, everything is working in my favor. Instead, to stop my mind from going down that rabbit hole of negativity. So this message, God is just saying, like, you can do this. Like, you can bring whatever you want to come about, but it's not going to happen overnight. It's not magic. It's not going to happen by you like constantly, you know, trying to figure your way out of it. It's the way it's going to happen is really by you learning how to trust God and to trust yourself and to learn how to take control of your mind and your attention and intentions. Okay. All right. The last card that I'm going to get for you guys is the blessing. And I want to know, God, what happens for us if we learn how to, you know, let go of our past? We learn how to stop focusing on our what is and really put our attention on what is becoming. What if we know that we're worthy of abundance and having everything that we desire? What if we really start to use that practice of, you know, shifting our attention, knowing that the law of attraction adds to our problems and solutions, and just start to be the king and swords of our life? What happens if we really truly understand that our intention to it invites the essence of it? What if we begin to make decisions from a happy place? Make it as plain as possible. That card also came out. My attention to it invites the essence of it. The blessing of oneness. Bring your awareness within and connect with the internal you. Love, abundance, and blessings flow to you. Feel a deep sense of peace. Feel the oneness and the clarity and the perfection and the love that you truly are. So God is saying, wow, again, all of this talk about coming within. So God is saying, bring your awareness within and connect with the eternal you, which means your soul. Love, abundance, and blessings will flow to you. Feel a deep sense of oneness and clarity, the perfection and the love of who you truly are. So what God is saying is the reason why you feel so pragmatic, the reason why you don't trust yourself is because you're looking outside of yourself. You're trusting everybody over yourself. Your everybody opinion is more important than your own. And so what God is saying, it's time to go inwards. It's time to really think about the life that you are trying to create and really asking yourself, do you feel worthy of the things that you are hoping for and you're praying for? And if you do feel worthy for it, angel number 2023, then be man and woman enough to take those steps by faith of to bring it about. The last blessing that God wants me to bestow on your life is the blessed treasure within. So again, all of this stuff about within, the qualities you admire in others, you also possess. There's a treasure within you. This card is here to help you reconnect with the well of wisdom, creativity, and beauty inside of you. It's time to shine your light. And so God is saying the reason why you love Beyonce so much, the reason why you look after Oprah, the reason why you feel this connection with Jay-Z and Drake is because deep down inside, you have those same qualities as those people. And if you would just shut out that noise, let go of your past, connect to your intuition, then you could really live just like them. But the choice is yours. So what are you going to do? Are you going to be a creator or are you going to be a fool? I don't like how I ended that. I want to do control or delete. The people that you admire, Though your soul, you admire them because your soul is recognizing that they have qualities and that you have the same qualities within you. In order to get to the place that you ultimately want to be, to get to bring that big ass vision to life, you need to stop focusing on what is happening now. Stop, block out the outside noise, get tunnel vision, focus on the goal, focus on yourself, and make decisions from love and a place of happiness. All right, y'all, that is all the messages I have for you. If it was beneficial for you, please give me your key takeaways. If not, at least let me know how you, at least give me a thumbs up. Until we meet again, dream those dreams, never let the internet rush you, and never ever let someone tell you what you cannot do. Angel number 2203, mwah, take care.